Hello, my fellow Cowboys fans. Welcome to this edition of Cowboys Imperial Postgame, although it's 2 days after the game, some postgame show. But nonetheless, go to the commercial.
Hi, I'm Michael Corleone, head of the Corleone. Family. My father taught me many things in this room. I remember this used to be his desk, and it was right here. He taught me, always respect the blue star, Michael. He taught me to keep my friends close, but my enemies closer. And lastly, he told me, when you want an olive oil that you can't refuse, make it Genco olive oil. There. Does that work for you?
Alright, welcome back. Go ahead and play me some music. I'm not ready to get obviously a disappointing way to conclude such a good season that we had in the 2009 season. We got our first playoff win in 13 years. We extended our consecutive winning season streak out to 5 years. We saw the emergence of Miles Austin, Felix Jones, Anthony Spencer, and Mike Jenkins. We saw Tony Romo develop into a leader. You know, like that should have been any surprise, but okay, we saw that. Ooh. We saw many good things. We beat the Philadelphia Eagles. I don't care if it was really Redskins or Giants, just the fact that divisional opponent 3 times in a season and 2 times in the span of 6 days. And we pitched back-to-back shutouts. Something we hadn't done in our history. We beat the Dallas Texans. We beat the New Orleans Saints. We ended their undefeated season. We did a lot of good things this season, and it's very disappointing to see it all end the way that it did. Now, when I make crow videos, I just make them in general. I'm sorry we lost and the opponent did a good job. But in this regard, since I had to, you know, like kind of become Cowboy Bill or whatever, because I didn't think he was going to make a video. So to show solidarity with him with the gallbladder, I did that. So anyway, congratulations to Speed Fork Freak, whatever. Congratulations to Purple in Wisconsin. And any other Minnesota Vikings fans here on YouTube, you absolutely beat the Dallas Cowboys. There's no question about it. I think that if when we play each other next year, you're not going to see the same performance like this. I think that the 34-3 game, yeah, we lost, but I think it was a snowball. You know, it wasn't really so much like 44-6 where, like, in the third quarter, oh my gosh, we're down 44-3 right now. You slowly took the momentum away from us throughout that game. And in the fourth quarter, you just boom. You know, you popped us like a zit. So, congratulations to the Minnesota Vikings. And, you know, I have respect for Brett Favre. You know, when he was with the Packers, and in the 90s, I hated him, you know, but when he became the old man, somewhere in about 2003, you know, then I started to admire the guy, and, you know, let's see what happens. Maybe you'll do something. Please beat the Saints. Please beat the Saints. I can't stand that team and their bandwagon fans. They come out now all of a sudden because they're doing well. Ooh, the Saints. Yeah, get out of here. So, I don't know what else you want me to say. Here's what I'm going to say. Since we lost 34-3, a bunch of haters and the bot flies in the living tissue called the Dallas Cowboys fan base are going to come out and they're going to say, ooh, the Cowboys, you know, we're back to square one. Ooh, things are horrible. Like this Jim Reeves here. I saw this on the Star Telegram off of DC Fanatics website. This Jim Reeves here, he writes, the re-signing of Wade Phillips as coach signals that we're no longer playing for anything meaningful here in Dallas. You idiot, you. You moron. Jim Reeves. You wear the hat of Tom Landry to try to drape yourself in it, to try to act like you know what a championship coach is, and then you're probably the same type of person that would have stepped on the fedora of Tom Landry had you been riding back in his day. You know, I don't trust any of these mediates at all, and you shouldn't either. Don't trust your friends. Don't trust the mediates. Don't trust anybody that's going to tell you about this team, because these are the same people that told you at the beginning of this season we'd go 9-7 and miss the playoffs, or 7-9, or whatever. They have no grasp on reality, so I'm not going to expect them to tell me what I should look at when it comes to the 2010 Dallas Cowboys. I know what to look for when it comes to the 2010 Dallas Cowboys. They can go someplace else. Play me some more music here. Yeah, the sunflower seeds. Yeah. Okay, alright. Another thing people are going to try to do is dog Romo, or I thought they were. They're not. Why'd I even mention it? Who cares? I don't know. I don't know what we need to address this offseason. I wouldn't be closed to the idea of trading Barber and or Bennett, to be honest with you. The areas of concern I see are tackle, middle linebacker, kicker, and secondary. We really don't need to do anything in free agency. Retain the guys we have, use the draft to build the depth of those other positions, and I think we're set. So, I'm real confident heading into 2010. I really am. I think that this loss is going to be the catalyst for something great. And with that said, let the interminable offseason begin. Let it begin. Before it begins, though, let me say this. Here's how I run my channel in the offseason. I don't come on here for anything to do with the Dallas Cowboys. So I'll put up my free association stuff, but other than that, I'm not going to be back till August. So if you're a subscriber, please stay subscribed. I will be back. But if you don't want to subscribe, go ahead and unsubscribe. What do I care what you do? So there you go. Let the interminable off season begin.